Welcome everybody, you're watching Mr. Fugu Data Science. Today is a dedicated video creating user credentials for the Python Postgres connection due to recent demand. We need to create two separate files, an INI file and a config.py file. Let's get into this. The INI file, I'll just call it practice db.ini. Feel free to use any editor, I'm using Vim. Use I for enter if you're using Vim. Create a header, which would be our Postgres connection. You need the host. Mine is localhost. I don't have a dedicated connection. You need your database that you're using. So your DB, the username, your password. Okay. Save this file. For me, I do escape colon W for write, Q for quit. Then create the other file, config file, and this is used to take in the data from your init file and output a dictionary. Now to create this next file, let's just call it, practice postgres config.py. So I'll do I for enter again. Let's do a bash command where we're calling the user /bin/python. And this is a great time that you could change this line here and take care of a virtual environment if you're using one. We need to import the config parser library and call specifically the config parser. And the config parser module allows you to basically implement a structure similar to the Microsoft INI files. The file contains sections. Of each section, you're creating key value pairs. You're able to write comments using two methods, which would be either the hash symbol or the pound symbol and a semicolon if you need to create any comments. So let's define a function that's called config where we take in our file name, which would be the database. Let's take in as the file name. For me, since I have a separate file with my user information, I'm going to call that in. And then the section, which would be Postgres. Let's close that out. And from here, let's create a parser where we're saying parser equals and then the config parser function. We need to also read in the file. So then we'll do a parser.read, which takes in our file name. And then we will get the section of Postgres, where the default will be Postgres. So then we're calling a dictionary that we're going to create, storing our key valued pair from the last file we created. And we need to check to basically see if the section of Postgres parser exists. So let's do that by saying if the parser has a section called section, then we will create some parameters from the parser.items. Since you're creating key value pairs for your dictionary, we're going to call the section, and then we need to iterate through the parameters where we need to store our key value pairs now. So we call then the param of 0, and then we need to also call in the param of 1, which would be our value. From there, we need to return an error. If the parameter is called that is not listed in the init file. So from here, let's raise an exception. So let's raise that exception, and then let's do some string formatting real quick. So we'll put in the section with our key not found in the value which is in the file. And in the formatting part, we need to call the section and the file name. Okay, so let's stretch that a little bit. And let's return our key value pairs. So let's save this file. Let's make sure that this thing works. So you need to import scikop-g to whatever your config file is called. Let me verify if this is right. Oh, I changed it. So let's do that. We we need to import sitecop g2 as well as the file that we just created for config with the function that's storing our parameters. If you do not have sitecop g2, feel free to pause the video and install it now. So do either a pip install or a conda install depending on your circumstance. Then we'll do this again. Now I'm calling in my config function that's storing my parameters, which are key value pairs. I'm calling in my parameters that were stored from the function of config, which are key value pairs. This will establish my connection. After that, I create what's called a cursor. The cursor allows me to either send or retrieve data as well as run queries. I'm using autocommit equals true, so after every instance of running either a query or sending data, it happens immediately. Now you're ready to get the ball rolling. You could run any queries or send any data you would like. All right, everyone, let's get into part two of this video, creating the config file for MySQL connection via Python. We need to create another ini file, so I'm just going to call it config_mysql, I guess, .ini. So I'm going to create this file, and then it's going to be similar setup. So we got our header once again. We have our host, so I'm using the localhost. Then you have your database that you want to connect with, the username, which is your name, and then the password, which is your password. Okay, then you go and you save this file once again, which is easy enough. You need to also create your new config file so that you could just call it, I don't know, MySQL Python config.py file, right? So you're going to enter that. And what is that going to look like? Well, it's the same exact file type as last time, the exact same for both of these. But instead of this, you put your new MySQL init file you just created, and you put MySQL here. And that's the only difference. And everything else in here is the exact same. If you want to tidy this up and just put MySQL here and MySQL here, and you're good to go. Easy as that. So then we could escape this and save it. So I'm not going to call these files in because they're just generic. And I'm going to remove those now so I don't get confused later. All right, now we're ready to turn on a MySQL instance. For me, I don't have it running as a service in the background, and I initialize it every time I use it. It's going to my terminal. I'm using a Mac, so it may be different for Windows, but I'll do a MySQL server start, set that up. Now this should let me make my connection now. So if you don't have MySQL connector, you should pause the video and do an install. I'm not sure if you have a conda installation you like to do or pip or pip3. Just depends on how your machine is set up. All right. Now let's import the MySQL.connector as MySQL. I will call a class. I want to do a MySQL connector, and I want to import the MySQL connection, which is a class and not a function. I want to also call in the file that I created with the function that's storing my key value pairs. Pull that in. I would like to now establish creating a connection, but I first need to create a variable where I'm going to call it dbconfig, establishing a variable, taking in the parameters or my key value pairs that are stored, make my connection for my MySQL connection where I need to put my parameters, my keyword arguments, establish my cursor, which will allow me to do the cursor will allow me to do my queries and send and retrieve data. And there you are. Now you're free to do anything you would like. I'd like to say thank you for watching. Please subscribe, turn on that notification bell, and throw a like. As always, I'll see you in the next video.
Bye.